Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Connor. I'm here with my father,
Kevin.
Before I say anything else, I'm going to get all the comments out of the way. It's so cool that Julian Casablancas is showing his dad his own album.
Exactly. Yeah, it's amazing.
Julian Casablancas is showing Jordan Peterson his own album. This is crazy. Look at Julian Casablancas with his own album showing his dad, showing this old guy here.
You know, I didn't get this whole thing until I actually went and looked at your face and your eyes.
And then looked at his. Yeah, we have some similarities.
And I was like, oh my God, look at it. It's like, it was crazy.
I'm like the Walmart version of Julian Casablancas. Okay, the Strokes.
Yeah.
What do you know?
I know that really right now that you sort of look, you're the Walmart version of the lead singer.
Okay.
That is it. I didn't even know the Strokes existed until... like you told me. And I promise you, with this whole thing, with, you know, how me and I talk about genitals and all that kind of shit. I'm not going to say anything about stroking or anything.
So they came out with their debut album in 2001, which was extremely influential at the time. Mm-hmm. And then they had four more albums after that, spaced out up until 2013.
Wow, they've been around.
Yeah, they've been around for a while.
Wow.
And they have hits off most of their albums, but it's the most recent one from last year, 2020, mm-hmm. That we'll be listening to today. And there's no exact reason why I want to show you it this way, like this order. I just like this album.
Okay, well, whatever you...
And because I think the go-to would be to show you their debut, because it's like such a classic,
but... Yeah.
I just feel like showing you this one.
And this is fresh too, right?
Yeah. And I like it a lot. So
okay.
Before we get into the video, I just want to give a huge thanks to our sponsor, Manscaped. Ladies and gentlemen, the holidays came early here at Manscaped. Manscaped just launched new products, including their all new ultra premium body wash and a 2-in-1 shampoo and conditioner. It's time to give yourself, or someone who needs it, the gift of beautiful skin, hair, and balls this holiday season. Their new 2-in-1 shampoo and conditioner has key ingredients with benefits that include hydrating, nourishing, conditioning the scalp, and strengthening your hair at the same time. As you can tell, my dad is having a lot of fun with the new Manscaped products here. Every guy out there needs to add Manscaped to their wish list this season. You guys can get 20% off plus free shipping using the code TTT20 at manscaped.com. That's 20% off free shipping using the code TTT20 at manscaped.com. Okay, let's get into this, starting with track number one, The Adults Are Talking.
I like it right off the bat.
Okay, that's good.
Say it after me.
Huh, yeah.
You like the mix?
Yes, I love it. Listen, those are wicked. This is really cool. I didn't expect this at all. I really thought it was some type of different...
Heavier rock or something?
Heavier rock. Oh, this is really cool. It is. And you know, when you said that... this would be something
that you would like,
that I would probably be
make
as a,
you get that
now? I get it now. I would make this. Look at there. See, yeah. It's got electric guitars and synths.
Yeah, it's got the, what's it called, the drums beat. Electronic drums.
You can sing, man.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He's, He's got a really unique voice.
This really is surprising me. No, it does. It's really nostalgic.
In a way, yeah.
Yeah, I can really... It's nostalgic in a way. But it's not.
At the same time.
Exactly, yeah. Oh, that's nice, Phil. This is cool. Wow! What was that? Someone's playing the skin flute.
The skin flute.
Listen, what a fool.
No, the mixing is so cool.
I'm tripping out, man. This guy overhears. They're going back and forth. One, two. Oh my god, he reminds me of Rick Ocasek from The Cars right there.
Mm.
Big time. That was fun as hell.
Yeah.
That was really good. Man, I totally pictured something different, more tons of heaviness.
Yeah, like a heavier rock.
Yeah, yeah, thing. Like the Strokes.
Yeah.
Stroke it.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? What?
Stroke it. I could totally understand why you would think that. Like, you probably thought it was going more like the Alice in Chains kind of direction, like the heavy.
I thought it was like the Strokes, like, you know, like the Clash and
yeah, it sounds
the
like,
Who.
Yeah, it's like, you know,
yeah.
It's got that power to it.
Of yeah. Just, heaviness. But you know what? Like I said, the Who and that heavy part. But man, there is so many elements of, and you're probably not familiar like I am of all the Cars. But there's so much Benjamin Orr and Rick Ocasek in this. It's crazy, and I wonder if those guys.
Oh, the band.
The car, yeah.
I was like, I know, like, you know, there's a Prius, there's a Civic.
No, but it's crazy. Like at the end, the spoken part there, it sounds like Rick Ocasek.
Yeah, I'm not super familiar with the Cars.
We should do the Cars. We should do Candio. Like, that's fantastic. That was really fun, man. And I'm anyways, I don't know. No, I'm surprised. I'm just really whacked that way. I just haven't heard them. Like,
we're actually still in track one because track one kind of flows into track two.
Yeah.
So we're going from the end of track one into track two.
Okay.
Selfless.
Oh, that's wicked. That is really nice. Oh, this is my wheelhouse, man. You know it.
That's what I thought.
Wow.
I knew you were gonna like this.
He's got some deep throat like you, eh?
You just ruined the song. Like,
you know what I mean. And he can go super high.
Yeah.
Like, I'm really loving this. Like, this is...
I really knew you would like this record. That's why I wanted to do this.
Like, it's got the Cars. It's got Paper Kites. It's a mix of, like...
It's a lot of stuff you
like.
A
lot of stuff. Wow. Now you have to edit out the deep throat part.
No, that's going in.
No, forget it. I don't want to be out there saying that. Holy shit.
Those high notes.
Wow. That was a nice phrase.
Yeah.
Oh, God, I got shivers on my back on that.
The last part?
Just the outro.
And that is track two, Selfless.
Okay. Let me just rephrase and let me just, you know.
What you said earlier.
What I said earlier, okay? He has a really deep voice like you, okay?
Okay, that's a way better way. I wish you would have said that.
Jesus, from talking about Kanye's package to your deep throat. Jesus.
You've just been on a roll lately. The shivery wivers, the Kanye's package. What was it? Kanye's well-rounded package?
Well-rounded package.
Yeah.
No. Oh, man. No wonder mom, when mom watches these, she just shakes her head and goes, oh, this is not cool.
Man, he's got the deep throat like you.
Anyways, back to the song. It was a fantastic song. And wow, he can go.
He can go deep.
He can go really deep, have his voice. And then he does that really super high part, man. It's a beautiful voice. He's a beautiful. This is a really good fucking band.
So I
liked them. And you know what? We haven't been listening to a lot of bands.
No, lately it's been a lot of other. Yeah, even I was going to say
Tame Impala was a solo project, right? Yeah. But this is the first band since Radiohead we've done, right?
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah. Yes. And no, they're really good. They're really, really good. I love all the elements. And I think that there is that nostalgic part in me that it's between the electric, you know, the 80s and that, all that kind of stuff. But they're, and then the synth stuff and the mix, it just makes me feel really good inside, right?
Track number three is titled Brooklyn Bridge to Chorus. I feel like every start of the song, you're just like, whoa.
I just... this is like... is sad.
It is. The lyrics.
Yeah. And this is, for me, this has got a bit of the Killers.
Yes. Yes, for sure.
Right?
Break.
Was that you or him?
That was him.
Oh, wow. I thought it was you with the deep throat.
With the deep throat.
I heard
break.
One shot is never enough for this way.
Oh my God, there's so many feelings this is bringing up. This might be my go-to right now.
Album?
Yeah, for like...
Just feeling...
No, really for inspiration, like for...
Yeah, that's what I thought it would be.
If I could mix this with some, like, you know, your Putty own. And all the stuff I've listened to?
Yeah.
Oh, man. Oh, I love the jangling of the guitars.
Yeah. Everything going on.
Everything about it. This is what you want to make. As a songwriter, you want to make this sound, right? Everything I do sounds so thin. Everybody's got really defined parts.
Right, yeah.
Like, I'm listening to the synth part and all that. They're like...
You could listen to the album five different times and just... Pay attention to one instrument each time.
Yeah, they're doing two different things, right? I love how this guy's mixing. He's going floor tom and he's going illum through this side from a right side to the left side. He did a couple of fills where it's like it really just fucked with
brings it alive.
And just woom woom. You're like, wow, this is crazy, right?
Yeah. So thoughts and opinions.
I like it, man. I like it. This is really cool for me right now. It is. It's a good feeling. What album was I talking about where I was talking about getting on a BMX? And
That was Currents because of the synths.
Yeah, the synths.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm getting that feeling with this, but I'm getting more of a more really nostalgic feeling because it really is. It's got that.
Like, it's got everything.
I keep going back, but it's like it's got some tainted love. feeling, right? That it's got those kind of scents in there. It's got the cars, especially. Like, I can really feel the cars, but I can feel the killers. I can feel the killers in here. Mm-hmm. Like, it's a good. These guys are very. They're completely original. But I'm just saying those elements that make you go, "Ooh, cut!" You know, very cool. I'm excited. You can tell I'm excited. I like this one. I want to actually go upstairs. I'm going to leave right now
and go listen.
No, I'm just going to play the synths and show.
Moving on to track number 4, Bad Decisions.
Got a beautiful tom sound.
Yeah.
He can sure change tone, eh?
Just right in so an quick. Instant.
This chorus reminds me of Billy Idol. Yeah. It's got the song. It's some of the phrasing is dancing with myself.
I am dancing with myself. I'm dancing with myself.
Oh yeah, you're right.
Yeah.
I didn't notice that. You've just ruined the song for me.
No, I'm kidding. I love this. That. A part of me wants his vocals higher.
Yeah, it's kind of mixed in like really tightly, right? Like
really tight under there, right?
Under there.
Like I would like to just hear just a bit, like, because he's got such a great voice.
Yeah. Like it's mixed right beside everything else.
Right. Yeah. It's. Oh my God, Julian, he sounds like, he goes from the cars to now he sounds like Bono on the, right there.
Yeah, he can go all over the place.
Yeah.
He's got a really cool voice.
Great bass sound too, man.
Yeah.
I love the way they just, at the end of that there.
Yeah, just, they calmed it all down.
Calmed it all down, but it literally sounded like they, like you had the beds in front of you.
Mm, right? Yeah, and you were just kind of pulling
them. You were just pulling them down, yeah. You were mixing it, and you were just pulling them down, and go, okay.
Yeah.
And it was like totally live, right? That was another good track, man.
What was I going to say?
You were going to say?
What were we talking? Oh, yeah, about the... No, just we were talking about the vocals.
Yeah, yeah.
So I noticed that too with the Strokes. You know, his voice is kind of mixed in with the instruments as opposed to like on top of everything.
I'm really curious to see if it's a Ruben thing, or like the previous albums, if like right at the beginning, all that kind of stuff. Or
no, it's kind of been like that with the other albums.
That's just the way they do their vocals. They want
to. Yeah, it's like his voice is. Part of the instruments, you know.
Yeah,
it's I mean, it works. I like it. It works well. But I can understand why. Like, he's got a great voice, so you'd want to hear it.
I'm not criticizing it. I'm just saying that it would be. I want to hear him like up in the when you're mixing, right? Mm-hmm. You know, we've talked about this before. You'd like to have him say the band's here, right?
Yeah, you'd want
to
have him.
I'd like to have him about here.
Yeah.
Not way out here, but just about here, so he's a little bit, because that's great tone, right?
Going into track number 5, Eternal Summer.
Oh, this sounds really good. Holy shit.
Right, I know.
Yeah. What a switch up, eh?
That's him.
Yes.
He just went from feeling friendly face to hate that feeling too.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
He's got a crazy vocal range.
Wow.
I love how that sound fills
the emptiness part there.
It's adding some chaos. It sounds like an ambulance or something.
Yeah.
Oh my God, it's got... You know what? I think this is so cool.
The ending?
Yeah. You know what? I really like this track, and I'll tell you why in a second here. First off, his voice is off the charts all over the place. It's amazing that it's one guy. Mm-hmm. Like, I'm picturing the bass player singing that high. He's going, boom, and then someone's going, the high part. It's like crazy, right? That he can do that.
Yeah, no, his voice is incredible.
And his voice is incredible because he's deep.
He's deep throat.
He's deep.
No, but what else do you like about that track?
No, I really like the, I'm going to say a million times here that when things get so formulated, and not saying this is formulated, but it's got a pop feel, right? Mm. That I really, really like. It's within my wheelhouse. I like that they, on this track here, they took that chance with that, with the chorus and stuff. I can't believe it's the 11th hour psychedelic. That's totally different.
Yeah, just switching it up.
And it's like, I love those shocks now. Where it's like, you know what I mean? It's like, someone said it brilliantly. I wish I would have printed it.
In a message or
in a comment on the last one. And he was talking, and it was talking about, the person was talking about, it was talking about Blonde and the way your mind works. I got to pull it up and read it because it was such a brilliant comment. But the way your mind works is that, like, at the beginning, you're like, what, this is strange. And then your brain gets around it and starts going, you know what? This sounds, it starts knowing it, and it becomes the norm and recognizes it. And you're like, oh my God, this is, and then it's new and it's so different. It's such a good feeling, right?
So like when the change came in this song, you were like ready for it. You were totally cool with that.
I was absolutely cool with it. Like you're going along and then it was just like this change. And now it doesn't shock me. I'm like.
Before you'd be like, whoa, what the fuck?
No, this is weird, man. This is, no, it didn't.
Turn this off.
It's got to go back to the A. It's got to go, why is he going to an F? You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But it's now it's just like, it's, I bring it on, bring it on.
Yeah.
Bring it on. Give me
the weird ending that kind of.
Yes.
The EQ'd down.
It was wicked, wicked, wicked.
Anyway. Let's get into track number 6, which is titled At the Door. I can't escape it. Never gonna make it out of this in time. I guess that's just fine. I'm not that quiet. I lost it all. Struck me like a chord. Wow. This is I got ball shivers.
Ball shivers.
Seriously,
my balls are shivering.
No, this is it. Yeah.
You know what I mean, though? When you feel it? Like, it's such.
That build up right there.
Yeah, just.
When the guitarist came in.
Yeah, just. It's, this is reminding me of Frank Ocean right now.
Yeah.
Because I'm like,
no drums.
When's it going to kick in?
It's a really cool atmosphere and just sea of different sounds.
It's great. That's, you know what? It's funny you said sea. Because that's what I'm picturing. It's like, you know, waves in an ocean. Like all this stuff is.
Yeah, that's how I imagine it too.
Thank you.
Yeah, that's wild.
I think you're ruined for life, though. Anytime a song doesn't have drums,
yeah,
even if it's just like an acoustic, some homeless guy is playing a guitar, you're going to be like, that's like Frank Ocean.
Totally. Look how deep he is here.
Yeah.
He's so far back.
In the mix.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
I think when he was, you know what, when he was doing the vocals for this, when Rick Rubin was recording it, he might have walked, Julian might have walked to the bathroom. Yeah. And he was in the bathroom and Rick was like, just let's leave it like that.
He was pointing the mic at him. Come on, we got to finish the song.
That was a beautiful track, man.
It was.
Really, 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 really nice track.
And you're now, your brain is ready for no drums, right? Like, you're okay.
I you know what? It's after Frank, man.
Like, you weren't like, where the fuck are the drums?
No.
What the hell's going on?
No. Frank really changed me in that terms. He's like, you can hear the lyrics. They're good and clear. And you know what's great is that I always thought that you needed that big, to get that feeling,
the emotion.
You don't need it when the melody's right and you have those synths and somebody's singing like that. That's what, you know. I wonder if they got that from Frank.
I think people have been doing it before Frank.
Yeah, I know. I just keep going back to Frank.
Someone rings on the doorbell. It's Christmas carolers, and they start singing for us. You must have listened to Frank Ocean. Yeah. Where are the drums? Where's your drummer?
Yeah, everybody. Yeah, where's Frank? Frank did this.
Yeah,
where's Frank?
You guys must have been listening to Frank at the time you made this. Wow.
Yeah.
Oh, great, great caroling. Track number 7. Why are Sundays so depressing?
I like it. Oh, wow. I love that snare sound, eh? It's so wicked. Wow. That's tripping me out there.
Yeah.
That wah wah.
Wah wah.
That's some cool shit, man.
There's a lot of cool shit going on.
Wow. Fuck, I love the drum sounds in this
fill,
song.
How the fills around.
Yeah, wow. Wow, this is... He's singing in there.
Yeah.
It's got to be guitar with some kind
of... Yeah, I think that's guitar for sure.
Phasey digital thing going on. I love that little guitar melody,
it's
man.
It's so cool,
that's what
right?
It makes it. Look at that.
Yeah. It could be a synth, though.
Could be a synth, yeah.
Yeah, there's a part where it sounded a little...
Well, that was not depressing.
No.
I thought it was going to be sad and depressing.
Not like an acoustic, just sad song. It's a little... It's pretty fun.
I love the differences in this, too.
Mm-hmm.
Like, it didn't... You think it's going to go somewhere, and then it just went... It went somewhere unconventional. See, the beginning of the album... I thought this whole thing would be exactly that feeling.
Like the first three tracks.
But now at the end here, they're starting to shake it up. The last couple of tracks are starting to shake it up a little bit. But that, he's got a great voice.
Yeah.
The part where you said he's got a good voice and it has a little bit of that, He had that growl. He can vocally do lots, man.
Yeah.
He's not a one-trick pony.
Oh, yeah. No, not at all. Okay. Second last track. Track number 8 is titled Not the Same Anymore.
Do you know what I mean when I talk about the paper kites feel?
Yeah.
That sweeping and that...
Yeah, the openness.
Openness and that...
But it's cool how they can do both.
They can do both. I know.
Because they'll bring it in tight and...
Super tight. I love those that they have these arpeggios that just stick.
Yeah.
Hear that there? You know what? All the guitar sounds on here are A's. Yeah.
They all sound like guitar sounds that you would want to use.
Yeah, and some of them like remind me of Radiohead's tone.
Oh yeah, for sure.
Like hear it like that.
Yeah.
You know what I love too, Connor, is that they, like you mentioned earlier, like the use of different drum sounds.
Oh yeah,
that makes it so interesting. Like real drums and not
and electronic.
Electronic.
Yeah, Radiohead went in that direction as well throughout their career, and it adds so much.
Yeah, it doesn't flavor. Make it. If it was regular drums the whole time, yeah, it'd be boring.
Get stale.
Yeah. That was some of the coolest guitar stuff I heard on this album in terms of the tones and all just everything about the guitar work, man. Like it's so fun how they're using they're employing all these different sounds mixed with their synths and analog drums and electronic drums.
And how it doesn't sound like out of place.
It doesn't sound out of place at all. It sounds good. This is really good shit. It's really good shit.
Good shit, yeah.
No, what?
No, I don't know. It's funny.
No, it's really good. Like it's just really good.
Yeah. So we're going to the last track, but I wanted to ask you. So completely not what you expected.
No. I pictured like I said with the Strokes, the Who, the Clash. You know what I mean? All that like. Like something like that, just because of the name, the Strokes, right?
No, that makes sense. Track number 9, which is titled Ode to the Mets.
Oh, I like the timing on this. Hey?
It's interesting.
Is it hitting those minor chords? It's feeling really strange. See, I crave for the off now. Really.
Sits back, sighs as he was.
Oh, yeah.
I got it all. I got it all. Waiting for me. Down on the street. But now you gotta do something.
He has such a versatile voice. It's sick.
Yeah, I
know. Wow.
It's all over the place.
I think it's always, I'm picturing in my head that when he changes, when he's doing the deep thing, I'm picturing a bass player doing the other parts.
Yeah.
Like a lot of other bands.
Yeah, but. Yeah.
I'll just say right before he starts up again, it is so hard to go from that deep to where he goes. And I don't know many people who do that.
Yeah.
Where he's like, oh, I'm back. And then he just shoots up.
It's crazy.
What, I'm just thinking Tom can do that.
Yeah, yeah, Tom Tom's, York.
Yeah.
Like on
No Surprises?
No. Jigsaw Falling in Place.
Yeah.
You know who he reminds me of here?
Who?
A little bit of Tom Chaplin. His voice.
Oh, from Keen.
Yeah.
Yeah. You're right.
Right?
Yeah. Big time.
Yeah, I just noticed that.
Actually. Right there.
Mm-hmm.
That long note, right? Good catch on that one. As a Keen fan, I should have got that. And
yeah. I'm less of a Keen fan than you, but...
Yeah.
Okay. Wow, that's... You know what? I've always liked stroking, and now I like the Strokes.
It's perfect. Now you can stroke to the Strokes.
Oh, man. Dun, 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 dun. That was something else.
Something you didn't expect.
It's something I didn't expect, like lots of these things, but I really thought this was a really heavy, heavy rock album.
Yeah. Well, yeah. The title, like you said.
Yeah.
The Strokes. They're a rock band.
Yeah.
You think. It's going to be heavy, loud.
Yeah.
Distorted guitars, some crazy
It wasn't
souls.
At all.
No.
Yeah. No. He has probably one of the coolest voices I've heard. Like, you know, I'm a huge Tom York
fan.
His voice is something else, right?
Mm-hmm.
But I don't think Tom goes that deep.
No. The closest is, I think, on Jigsaw. He goes like, yeah, he has that.
But Julian goes like from, and then right up.
Yeah.
Like, it's so quick how
super
fast he goes.
Deep throating.
Yeah. Yeah, that's okay. Again, I know you're not going to cut that because
people
are making comments is that his dad says, you got to cut that. And then he doesn't cut it. So,
yeah. Anytime you say you got to cut that, I'm putting it in there.
I'm not going to say that then.
Okay. Well, it's just going to go in now. It doesn't matter what you say. I'm the editor.
I realize that now, no matter what. How many times I screw up.
So I was going to ask you now, I actually have two questions to ask you. One, are you curious or interested in listening to more The Strokes albums?
I would like to, I'd like to go right back, actually.
Yeah, go listen to the debut.
I'd like to listen to the debut, yeah. I'd like to find out what...
I think that's what we'll do for the next time we do The Strokes.
Yeah, it'd be really interesting to hear how they progressed and came to this, right? And this is... and go ahead, sorry. What was the next one?
Oh, and then my second question for you was more of just... Now that you've listened to this, do you think you are going to take some of these elements into consideration when you're making music?
Yes, I'm going to definitely use and copy or borrow or whatever you want to call it. Some of the sounds I'm going to go back and try to recreate these sounds. And it's Ruben who did this album, right? He did
the producing.
He did an amazing job on the production side of having these guitar sounds, right? And not muddying up the mix. It could be really hard.
you know, you have so many things going on in terms of guitar, that frequency of guitar, mm-hmm. and then you get them in there, it starts to sound all muddy, and it's just like, okay, there's too much shit going on, right? But a couple of the tracks here, there's so much going on guitar wise.
But he balances it.
But he balanced it, and one of the great ways he balanced it was to changing the tonality of the effects. So some of the stuff was super clean, but a little bit of this, and then some was dirty.
Yeah.
But they all weren't in that same frequency range.
No, so it just made it clear.
It was clear. Like, they were all defined. Like, you just put them here and here and here, and all wasn't in that center spot. My only thing is, like, and it's only a thing that I would like, because
the vocals.
I would just, on some of the tracks, that one he had some, when you were talking about Tom there.
Yeah, Tom. Tom York.
No, Tom Chaplin.
Oh, yeah.
From the Keen.
Chaplin or Chaplin?
Chaplin, sorry.
Yeah. I don't know. No, you're the Keen fan.
I know. No. is that, that's, his vocals were opened up there and clear, right? And some of the earlier tracks on this album, he was like a little bit too deep in the mix, right? Just because I just want to hear him. He's fucking, he's got a really good voice.
I think it will grow on you, though. I think that's something that will, you'll learn to appreciate over time. More listens.
Oh, for sure. And then, you know what, there's a reason why that they've done that, right?
Yeah.
It's not just, you know, they just don't arbitrarily go, okay, well he got a great voice, let's pull that down.
Well, think about it. If his voice was a lot higher in the mix and you heard it, do you think you would have caught all the stuff that was going on?
You must be reading my head, because I was just thinking the same thing. If he was up out front,
you'd probably be really focused on his vocals. Be like, wow, like the whole video, you'd probably be like, he's an amazing singer. But you got to, you know, really pick up on all the instrumentation
and his voice
at the same time. So they definitely produced it this way on purpose.
Yeah, that's for sure. Yeah, and Ruben's a master, man. It's like, you know.
Yeah. So
you know, remember what he did with Hurt? Do you have you heard Hurt?
By
Nine Inch Nails. Yeah, and then Johnny Cash did it. Yeah, it's like, oh, man, the mix on that, it's just like, you get shivers, man. It's just magic, man. That's really good. That was really, really good. And it was unexpected left field, right?
If you made it all the way to the end, we really appreciate that. Thank you guys for watching today. Big shout out to our sponsor once again, Manscaped. You can use code TTT20. For 20% off. That's TTT20 for 20% off. Do you want to say it too?
Say it.
No, so. I want you to.
Wow. Okay. Try. What was the beginning again?
Thank you to our sponsor, Manscaped, okay. TTT20.
Okay. And, fuck, I suck ass.
You don't have to say
okay. Just want to say thank you. And wait, huh? What did you say? Just want to say thank you?
Whatever
okay.
you want.
Okay, whatever. Okay, ready? I'm just going to be casual. A big thank you to our sponsors, Manscaped, for sponsoring this video. You can use the code TTT20 for 20% off and free shipping. Get your orders in before Christmas and the holidays. Thank you.
Wasn't too bad. You sounded a little robotic, though.
Did I? Okay.
Like, it didn't sound like you were like just talking. It was like, it sounded like you were actually doing an ad read.
Did it? Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you.
No.
Okay, wait, hold on. Wait, okay, wait.
Now you sound like Shivery Wivers, like a game show host.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Wait, I'm going to do it. It's going to be good.
And thank you to our sponsor, Manscaped, for 20% off. Use the code.
Manscaped.
Okay. And thank you to our sponsor, Manscaped, for the code 20...
Fuck it. You're not good at this.
I can't do this. That's why I never got a job in voiceover. I seriously suck. Can you imagine the poor producer at, like, Pixar, and I'm doing the voice of some squirrel?
Yeah, fucking doing Finding Nemo. Anyway, thank you guys for watching. We love you very much, and we'll see you next week.
Yeah. Take care.
Bye.
All the best.